deficit with 20 and 13 strikeout efforts. He starts with Chris Steins. The very first red he faces gets some heat. Then it's Ed Taubmansee, remarkably leading the National League in batting. But he gets caught looking, as does Reggie Sanders. But Woods has a nail-biting fetish, and that might affect him, Dave.
Well, they certainly were examining it the whole game. David Weathers in the third inning. All of a sudden, for the first time in three games, the control starts to desert him. Finally goes 3-2 and then walks him. And six pitches later, all of a sudden, Kerry Wood looks like he may be getting in some trouble.
Dimitri Younger now gets the benefit of playing in left field instead of right, where he can't really field. Strikes out on a chase and a fastball out of the zone. Willie Green looks at a curveball, and then Sean Casey's in a horrific slump since coming back to the lineup. Also strikes out, and Weathers is not going to walk this time. Seven strikeouts through five, and needed 10 for the three-game National League record. He needed 14 to tie Nolan Ryan. But Jose Hernandez breaks open a tight game with this bases-loaded single off Weathers to score Grace and Rodriguez. Then Wood gets Brett Boone swinging, but eventually that cut, which may have been caused by a soda pop can, eventually got to Wood. He had to leave the game. Mark Grace hit a two-run homer, finishes the week batting over 400. All five of his homers this season have been this week. Terry Mulholland came on after the Wood injury, his first major league save. The Reds promoted Wood's record attempt and drew 33,000, but wild. Unbeaten on the season, he walked Craig Biggio to lead off the game on four pitches. 3-1 count, he walked Bill Spires. He walked Moise Alou. The bases are loaded. Now he's facing Carl Everett, gets ahead of him and strikes him out. He nubs one down the first baseline of Richard Hidalgo. The scoop on the leather side, and he gets two outs. He's got one more guy to get, and he gets Jack Howell on the splitter. But in the third, he attempted fate once too often.
Well, yeah, sometimes if you're facing a guy like John Smoltz and you blow an opportunity, you don't get another one. But John wasn't on today, and Moise Alou has been. He's 16 for his last 32. Drives one into the corner, two score, 2-0 Astros.
In the fourth, it was 3-0. Two on again, two outs, and Smoltz facing Alou. Gets one up over the plate, and Alou pounds it. Didn't quite get it out, but in the gap, it'll score Tim Bogar and Spires. It's 5-0 Houston. Sean Bergman is one of the surprises of the year.
He's been unbelievable. He and Jose Lima picked up the slack with the loss of Darryl Kyle, Chris Holt, and Ramon Garcia out with injuries. Those two guys have saved the Astros. They've been huge.
He retires the first 13 batters he faces. The Braves' first. The next Dodger teammate, Mike Piazza, would draw first blood. Hammers this roller off Royce Clayton. Kettmerker gives up the run to Edgar Renteria. Piazza's only hit on the day, but it did drive in a run. Mark McGwire had a walk in his only appearance against Chris Hammond. Got a couple of more today, but went 0-3. The next batter who really did the damage, Brian Jordan. A pitch up in the zone and away. He goes with it. John Cangelosi runs out of room. And Dave, what happened on this play?
Well, I think Kanji, he knew he was at the warning track, but he didn't know he was quite at the wall yet. You watch as Kanji goes face first and his glove hits the wall. If he could have gotten there and elevated straight up, he might have caught it.
Of course, Devo is a little taller than Cangelosi. Maybe that would have made a difference. Edgar Renteria on the D can't make the play. What a day for Jordan. That was his least impressive, but he went 5-for-5, and he was back to the more conventional stuff. A line single to score Ray Lankford. He knocked in four runs. He has been on a hitting rampage, batting over 500 in the last week and a half. The Cardinals, Kevin Elster. And Elster would knock in the hot-hitting Will Clark to break a scoreless tie in the fourth. It's not that the Indians didn't have their chances, Dave.
Yeah, but you know, one thing about the Indians, in the first 40-plus games this year, they have not played very well fundamentally. Kenny Lofton at first base, Omar Vizquel lines one to right field. Nice catch by Juan Gonzalez, but not a brilliant catch. What's Kenny Lofton doing so far off the base? Similar mistake is coming up in the sixth inning. Omar Vizquel, usually a great base runner, he's on second. Jim Thome loops one to center. Again, not a diving catch by Tom Goodwin. And they double Vizquel off. Two bad base running plays, and Mike Cargrove not happy.
Grover not interested in that kind of play. Aaron Seeley's yellowhammer working to perfection against Jeff Branson. Pitched eight full, struck out nine. And he got Vizquel, who was batting 600 against him in his career, to pop out. What a play by Fernando Tatis. Especially in an enemy crowd, he goes three rows deep, makes the grab. Wetland, despite an aching wisdom tooth, got a 1-2-3 ninth for the save. Seeley's the first in the majors to seven wins. He lowers his ERA. Wouldn't figure in the decision. Taken to the eighth, the Angels were up 3-1. But back come Thompson's teammates in his absence. Off Pep Harris, Joe Randa's first home run for the Tigers. Later in the same inning, bases loaded for Bip. Roberts off reliever Rich DeLucia, leader into center field. Bobby Higginson would tie the game at three. They win it on a sac fly by another rookie, Paul Baco, and win it 4-3. Bryce Flory is 3-0. Todd Jones picks up his sixth save. They got just four hits, but they got four runs on it to beat Anaheim. Reliever Tom Fordham comes in to try and protect that 7-2 lead. Henderson singles. Jack Voit would double. 7-3 now. Ben Grievous had a huge series. Walks. Jerry Manuel goes to Bill Seamus to try and get the righty with the bases loaded. And Mike Blowers is Mr. Bases Loaded. Call him Mr. Salami. That's the seventh grand slam of his career. It's suddenly a 7-all game. Manuel doesn't have too many other options. Leaves Seamus in. Scott Spezio drills a shot that would score Giambi. Break the tie. They go on to win it 9-7. A remarkable comeback by the A's.
Well, Matt Karchner is still out after undergoing.
Continues. They came in with a six-game slide. Todd Helton robbed at first by Dave Nilsson, the converted catcher. Fires home to Mike Matheny. Larry Walker's caught in a rundown. This is the old 3-2-5-1-6. Top of the seventh, Jamie Wright was pitching well. He gets Matheny swinging. One earned run, four strikeouts for Wright through eight innings. One all game. Woodall gives up the shot to Jeff Reed, his fourth of the year. Brad Woodall on a relief of Paul Wagner, who left this game with an illness.
Mike Lansing had tied that game with
ERA. Two on here on the first. Charlie Hayes singling to left and bringing in Darrell Hamilton. The first run that Leiter has given up all year in the first inning. Bernard Gilkey here in the seventh. The Mets down 3-2. Doesn't like the call by Wally Bell. Bell doesn't like the vocabulary. In fact, Gilkey says a few words that even we haven't tried to say yet here. Mets trailing. Barry Bonds looking for some insurance in the seventh inning after Gilkey was run. The Giants up 3-2 with two aboard. Watch Butch Husky. Chases this baby down, but opens the door for a run to come in. As it does, Giants take a 4-2 lead and hold on for the victory. Mark Gardner's first win since April 21st. Al Leiter remains winless.
Coming in, bottom third, trailing 1-0, gets Kilby Alvarez. Can I say it, Dan?
Ball, second time he struck out.
Yeah. One of 10 Ks for Shea. Here's a sack fly, but when it's Tony Gwynn, and it's his 1,000th career RBI, it's not boring video. We're going to show it. 3-1 pod, standing over Gwynn. He'd been out with a knee problem. Kevin Jordan down the line of Trevor Hoffman. And Giavanola. It's not Caminiti, it's Giavanola. Kind of a long name to play third for the pods.
His Dodger debut on Saturday. He's got the wiggling bat, and he goes against the Expos. To single off Mike Johnson, Eric Young, the leadoff hitter, comes around and put LA up 1-0 in the first. Sheffield had a couple of hits and a couple of walks. Dodgers down 3-1 by the third, though. Ramon Martinez had given up quite a bit, but Derek May goes out swinging. Charles Johnson gets Rondell White stealing to end the inning. By the fifth, it's tied, and Bobby Bonilla is up against Mike Johnson, hitting the cleanup spot. He doubles down the right field corner. Sheffield will score on this one. Dodgers eventually win this one 6-3. Martinez is 5-2. Radinsky picks up his eighth save. Dustin Hermanson, who just won on the DL, was replaced by Johnson, who didn't pitch that well in his call-up. Sheffield
didn't pitch badly, but made one big mistake. Gone. Glenn Allen Hill, former Blue Jay, has just left the building. M's on top 3-0, second homer of the game for Hill. Bases loaded for the Jays, down 3-2, bottom of the seventh. Tony Fosses facing Carlos Delgado. Got the lefty-lefty matchup they wanted, and he walked in. Brings in the tying run. We're tied at three. Bottom nine, tied at three. Alex Gonzalez at third. The winning run, Jose Canseco at the plate. With two outs off Heathcliff Slocum. Brings in Gonzalez. The Jays win it by the final of 4-3. Canseco, three hits, two walks. Delgado, two for three, two RBIs. The Blue Jays die. Jason Veritek is going to try to score. Die makes a good throw. Veritek misses the plate. Sal Fasano misses the tag and then finally gets him. Bottom six, Sox down 3-2. Two on, Lou Maloney. Larry Sutton slips, can't get there in time. Troy O'Leary scores, a double for Maloney. Game tied at three. Sox would go up 4-3 on a sack fly. We don't show sack flies. That's boring video. Sox up 5-3, top nine. Tying run at the plate. Veritek calls for the deuce and the whiff. Tom Gordon, still one of the better breaking balls in the game. Gordon's 16th save. Sox win it by the final of 5-3. Boston improves to 15-1 against left-handed.
To Camden. What a weekend. You talk about the leather on the sap. How about the leather by Roberto Alomar robbing Randy Witt?
The only way he can make is with the glove hand. Haven't seen that good a play since La Miz.
With a fourth, Roberto at the plate. Not quite as successful with the lumber. Jason Johnson gets him on Uncle Charlie. Harold Baines, he smokes. Next batter is Cal Ripken Jr. Orioles waste a chance because they can't catch up with the breaking ball. Devil Rays build a 7-3 lead. Hank Baines robbed by Aaron Ledesma. So the one-time Oriole product gets him out. The Devil Rays go on to win it 7-3. Esteban Yan pitched in this game and gave up a home run to his old teammates, but the Devil Rays